Get back! Get away! Get away!
Get back!
Get back!
Sierra Oscar 1 from Sierra Oscar, Wellstead
yes, sir.
Street, by
yes,
the
sir, we
park.
Have received several reports. Can you tell me, is anybody hurt?
Regarding cause of the explosion, Sarge?
A policeman.
One moment.
Sarge, a policeman's been hurt.
No details as yet, Gary.
Address,
one
please.
Possible injury. Fire brigade and ambulance on way.
Do we have any idea who the injured person might be?
It's on Ridge Hollis's beat.
If there's any danger of further explosions, we'll need to evacuate the area. Send another car down there.
Right, what about radios, sir?
Remind everyone to switch them off within 200 metres of the site, in case it was an explosive device.
Sir!
Unlikely to be a gas explosion.
A lot of phone boxes on the mains.
What do you reckon, Tony and Bum?
It's got to be. Why here?
And why a phone box? You think Reg was the target?
I'll let Mr. Munro know.
You all right, Reg?
Yeah, I think so.
It's a shock. Whoa, here you go. Yeah, ambulance is on its way.
On the road, then wait here.
Yes, sir.
Could you move back, please? Thank you. What happened?
Oh, sir, well, I don't really know. There's some lads over there, 16-year-olds, I think. And, the next thing was there was a bang, and then I hit the deck, and, I seem to be all right, though.
Well, I'm glad to hear it, Reg. See him into the ambulance, Eddie. Then help the others create a sterile area of about 100 metres around the phone box, and that means getting rid of this van.
Sir.
Yeah. It's not every day someone tries to blow you up, is it?
What, you reckon you were the intended victim?
Well, it's possible.
Oh, do me a favour, Reggie, want to try and kill you? Now, second thoughts.
Was it a bomb, sir?
Oh, from what I can see at the phone box, looks like it. Check these houses are all empty in case of secondary device.
Sir.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 1.
Go ahead, sir.
Confirm incident involving possible improvised explosive device.
On disposal.
Informed. We can't get hold of Mr. Brownlow yet, though.
Well, I'm sure we can manage without him, June. Look, just give me a minute, will you? Then you can give me a full report.
No sign of booby traps or secondary devices. It's pretty amateur stuff.
It was a bomb.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Well, no more when we've analysed the pieces, but I think we can rule out any terrorist involvement.
My officer reported some youth seemed anxious to keep him away from the phone box when it exploded.
Kids, that fits. Your bloke was lucky they distracted him. It's a pretty crude device to set some sort of firework fuse. Could have gone off any time. Just keep people away till the forensics get here.
Better go to St. Hugh's, Eddie. Check on Reggie's condition.
Well, wouldn't it be better if I stayed to help, sir?
If I thought that, I'd have said so.
And Mr. Monroe has reported the area safe, sir. No further devices located.
I'll have a bother shouting, and Mr. Brownlow's still stuck in traffic.
Yeah, well, Mr. Monroe's letting the residents back into their houses.
Desperate for breakfast by now, I should think. I'll just go and have a quick word with the troops. Stand them all down.
Lively start to the morning.
Mr. Monroe overreacted, making a major incident out of it. Just a kid's prank, not World War III.
Well, how was he supposed to know? Reg saw him. And look at the damage. It's no big deal.
Certainly not worth a mass evacuation. Just gets up people's noses.
Yeah, and what if they've been wrong? What if there'd been another device in the area?
Hardly likely.
Still, makes you wonder though, doesn't it?
What?
And what is it all about?
We'll probably never know, Gary.
I repeat, the Canley Park area is now safe.
So he'll please.
We need to keep one unit there to secure the scene for forensics.
Right, sir.
How's Reg? Do we know?
He's fine, sir.
Good.
Right.
Come on, June, I'll treat you to a cup of tea.
Hold on one moment. Sir, there's been another explosion. Plotherway Primary School.
What the hell's going on?
Any unit, Sierra Oscar, Plotherway Primary School.
Reports of an explosion, over.
Sierra Oscar from 8-5, show us dealing.
Ambulance and fire brigade informed on way, casualties reported.
Who'd want to blow up a primary school?
Mr. Monroe's gone straight from the park for a situation report. Vicky and Sam are staying there to maintain the sterile area until the exhibits officer's been.
Well, get them out of there as soon as possible, June. We need all the help we can at the school.
Right, sir.
The school? It'll be chaos! But June, I want details of all casualties fast, right?
Sir?
No ambulance yet.
Right.
Beating heavy, I've got more dressings.
Who's in charge here, please?
I'm the headmistress, Mrs. Clulow.
Are these all your injured?
Yes, mainly cuts, bruises, shock, apart from him. We were lucky, it was before most of the children arrived.
What happened?
An explosion, I think, in the boys' cloakroom. I moved all the children out immediately in case of any more.
So what was it, gas?
No, it makes no sense. There's no gas in there.
There's no one in there now?
I got all the children out.
You've checked the register, yeah?
Well, no, we haven't taken that, so I can't really be certain.
Why do these things always happen when they're digging up the motorway? Bad journey, sir.
Terrible. That and the station not being able to get hold of me left you in the lurch.
Nah, I'm quite capable of handling this, sir.
Yes. Yes, I know that. Well, I'm here now, so there's no need. Get down to the school for me and give me a situation report.
Yeah, but Andrew will be there in a minute. I feel I'd be more used running the incident from here, sir. Continuity of control.
I don't think that'll be necessary in this case. I'll be taking over. To be honest, Eric, you're surplus to requirements. Oh, take June Ackland with you, will you? She's good with people.
So you were with Craig during the explosion. Can you tell me what happened?
He had a bomb.
Where?
In his bag.
What sort of bomb?
A bit of pipe.
What sort of pipe?
Metal. I don't know, I didn't really see it.
Why's that?
Miss Maguire came in. She gets really cross.
So Craig hid the bomb?
I was scared.
What did he do with it? Put it in his bag again?
I ran to his locker. He pushed the bag in and...
Oh. It's all right, William. Do you know why Craig had a bomb? Where he got it?
He borrowed it from his brother. It was under the bed. That's all I know.
So... Have you got his details?
Craig Wendell, Sarge, age 10. I've got his name and address.
Go in the ambulance room, sir.
We are sure it was another bomb.
Well, that's what's been reported, sir.
Shall I take a look, then?
Yeah, the scene of the explosion was actually the boys' cloakroom.
I'll just get my kit.
A journalist already?
I'm afraid so, sir.
That's all I need. What paper?
It's the Sun Hill Chronicle. And Mr. Carter, he wants to speak to you about the explosions.
No, it's far too early to be briefing the press. Tell him I'm busy with you. On second thought, show him up. I don't want him going off half-cocked thinking this is some sort of major incident. If he spreads alarm, it could hamper our operation.
No one would object if you decided to call it a day and go home early, Rich.
Look, I'm fine, Eddie. The doc said so.
Oh, and he's got personal experience of being blown up, has he?
Well, no, but he's had the training. Anyway, I've been putting out a spit for two, you know. To be honest with you, I'd rather keep busy. Obviously, I'm glad you and I have been teamed up as well. I wouldn't want to be out on me toe. Who are we going to pick up anyway?
Adam Wendell thinks it's okay to keep bombs under his bed.
Oh, well, there you are. Want to pick him up by yourself?
Oh, I can handle him. He's hardly likely to put up much of a fight once he knows his kid brother's been injured. And we don't want you coming over all funny with delayed shock or something.
Look, Eddie, I appreciate your concern, but I'm fine, all right?
I tell you, Reg, you didn't hear what the bloke from the bomb squad said. Eh? You were lucky not to be shredded.
I've never known you'd be so caring, Eddie. Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Take a seat. Can I take your coat?
Thank you.
I understand this is about the two small explosions that occurred this morning.
That's right. Bombs going off all over Sunhill.
I'll do that, Mr. Carter. Two explosive devices, that's all.
What sort of explosive devices? Can you give me any details?
No, I'm afraid not. It's early days yet.
A policeman was injured, wasn't he?
He was slightly shaken, but he's back on duty.
Unlike the boy at the second one. What's the likelihood of there being any more devices around?
We believe these were isolated incidents. We do have the situation under control. There's no cause for alarm.
Really? I hope the injured boy's parents agree with you.
Well, of course, our sympathy goes out to them, but he was the only person seriously injured.
So far. Who planted the devices? Has anyone claimed responsibility?
Oh, we're confident it wasn't terrorist activity. You can reassure your readers on that count.
So, who is responsible?
I'm afraid I can't be more specific at this stage.
Do I take it that you don't actually know who's responsible, let alone what they've used?
Mr. Carter, I said I can't be more specific at this stage.
The governors don't like any kind of police activity taking place within the school.
Yeah, well, it's very kind of you to cooperate with us, Mr. Roth.
And they're not going to be very happy if it gets out that one of our pupils is messing about making bombs. Do you understand me?
Well, yes, sir, of course.
Yeah, if we could just speak to Adam, please, Mr. Roth.
Yeah.
Adam Wendell, we want to talk to you about an explosion this morning.
I don't know anything about an explosion.
Adam, it's not just about the park. Although, of course, I do recognise you as one of those present. Now, it's about your brother.
My brother?
Yes, he was seriously injured this morning in an accident at the Plover Way Primary School.
What do you mean? What happened?
Another explosion.
It's got nothing to do with me.
He found the bomb under your bed, Adam.
He shouldn't have taken it. How could I know he'd be that stupid?
Where did you get the bomb?
I found it.
Where?
I don't know.
Adam, you have to tell us. It is important.
It was Josh. He made them. We just thought it'd be a laugh. We didn't mean for anyone to get hurt, honest.
Oh, I'm sure you didn't.
Well, who's this Josh?
Josh Hayward. He's in Adam's class.
Right, you stay with Adam, Reg, and we'll go and get him, sir, if that's okay with you.
Of course. The sooner you get this cleared up, the better.
Is Craig going to be all right?
Look, I'll tell you what, when we get back to the station, I'll bring the hospital, all right, see if I can find out.
The station?
Yeah, well, we need to ask you a few more questions. It'd be easier if we do it back there.
I think I'm going to be sick.
Look, you're going to be okay, all right? It'll be the shock, that's all. Yeah, have a tissue. Deep breaths. There you go. Now you're going to be all right, okay? You all right?
There's a water fountain outside. Could you just...
Yeah, I'll get some.
What are you doing, Rich?
Oh, he was about to fall out everywhere.
Brilliant. And he's prepared to talk to me?
Absolutely, sir. In fact, he seems desperate to get it off his chest.
What's his name again?
Josh Hayward.
Morning.
Sir.
Hello, Josh. I'm Chief Superintendent Brownlow. I'd like to ask you some questions.
Are you in charge?
That's right.
Is it true that Alan's brother's lost his hand?
Yes, I'm afraid it is.
It's awful. Really bad. When we set the first one off in the flower bed, nothing much happened. I didn't know they could cause that sort of damage.
And then you moved on to the telephone box?
I never thought anyone could get hurt. Not till I saw that... this policeman. I really didn't.
Well, you know now. A hard way to learn.
That's right. That's why you got to find the others.
Others?
The other bombs. You have to find them. Make them safe.
How many?
Not counting the first test. There were 10.
And where are they?
Sold them to mates.
Who? We need to get somebody around to all the addresses straight away.
That's the point. I don't know who's got them all.
What do you mean?
I only made the bombs. Adam was in charge of sales and marketing.
So he knows who bought them. Where is Adam now?
I don't know. He ran away. But you got to find him. He's the only one who knows where the bombs are.
Captain Evans will be here in 5 minutes, sir.
Right. Captain Evans is from Bomb Disposal. He needs to hear from you exactly what sort of devices he's dealing with.
I'll help when I can.
Good. You said that you knew where two of the bombs were.
There's one in my garden shed. That's where we made them. I sold one to Hong Lee from my class. He lives on the White Gate.
Which house?
Bronte, number 29. He'll be there.
I'll get onto these straight away, sir.
Right, thanks. And what about Adam? Would he have gone home?
No way. His father, like, really goes ape. Even over little things. I don't think he'll be able to go home for months, if ever.
So where do you think he'd go?
There is the temple.
What?
It's what we call it. It's a place where a few trees make a sort of shelter.
And where are these trees?
On a bit of wasteland behind the training estate.
Can you be more specific?
I could show you.
Good. After Captain Evans has talked to you. I shall leave you two to retrieve the situation. I don't need to tell you how important it is to find Adam.
No, sir.
No. Try not to lose him this time.
Sure.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar. 6 Kitchener Close, residence of Josh Hayward. Suspected improvised explosive device in the garden shed.
Received.
Vic and Sam are free to deal with the other one, sir.
Good. Under no circumstances are you to touch the device, Gary.
Teenagers mass producing bombs. What next?
Well, the information is very easy to get hold of these days.
Well, I wouldn't know where to find it.
With respect, sir, you're not 16.
What exactly are we dealing with?
Well, according to Josh, these are very basic pipe bombs. Detonated in the open air, they have little power, but in a confined space, they can cause a great deal of damage. The real danger is from secondary hazards. Ruptured gas pipes, boilers, shrapnel, that sort of thing. That's why we have to treat these things cautiously. They may be small, but they can still cause one hell of a bang.
But they are basically stable.
I wouldn't say that at all. The explosive mixture these lads have used is extremely unpredictable, even in the hands of an expert.
Let alone a pair of teenagers who've bunged in a bit of this and a dollop of that.
What would your mum have said if you'd have done something like this?
Nothing much. Just killed me.
Anyway, what the heck were you going to say? Did you know your son's got a bomb factory in the garden shed?
How about all those without a bomb in their back garden take one step forward? Where do you think you're going, Mrs. Hayward?
Mrs. Hayward?
Yes, what's happened? Is it Josh?
No, he's fine. We just need to speak to you.
You better come in.
Actually, Mrs. Hayward.
We'd rather not.
Why would anybody want to buy a homemade explosive device?
A laugh, I suppose. Boys will be boys.
We're talking about explosives here, Derek. You can't trivialise a child losing its hand.
Precisely, sir. And that's why it's important we find these devices before somebody else gets injured.
We need to find Adam Wendell.
Yes. But in the meantime, publicity might bring people forward.
I've already had that report on the Chronicle on my back.
Well, use him. Get him on our side.
He'd only twist it.
Well, what about an amnesty, then? Reassure people that if they come forward, it'll go no further.
We can't be seen to condone this sort of behaviour, Derek.
We're talking kids here, sir, worried about getting into trouble. We must have an amnesty, or they'll try and dispose of these things themselves with catastrophic results.
Well, you leave me to worry about that, will you, Derek? You should be out there dealing with the devices we've found already.
Bomb? Here? Don't know what you mean.
Josh Hayward gave us your name. He said you bought one of the devices from him this morning.
You got the wrong bloke.
Well, you are Huang Li.
So what if I am?
Why are you at school, Huang?
I'm sick.
You don't look very sick to me.
How would you know?
These devices are highly unstable, Mr. Li. You've got to tell us where it is. It's for your own safety.
What would I want with a bomb?
Look, you've got to get out and let the bomb squad deal with it.
Look, how many more times do I have to tell you? I've got no bomb, end of story.
Sierra Oscar from 416 receiving, over.
Go ahead, Sam.
We're having problems at the White Gate, Sarge. He denies any knowledge.
416 from Sierra Oscar 5-4, I'm on my way. Stay there. I'd sooner they just didn't go barging in. And no one else will cooperate at all.
We're going to have to ask you to leave, OK? We'll let you straight up. The bomb squad's here already.
Bomb squad?
If you wouldn't mind just going down, my colleagues look after you down there. We'll let you back in a jiffy.
It's OK. It's just a safety precaution. Just find someone to stand well back. It's all clear here, sir. Do you want to handle your things?
No. Why can't we just get in there and find it, Sarge?
Because if you don't know where it is, you're putting yourself at risk.
Yeah, I don't fancy cruising around in his drawers looking for a bomb anyway, thank you very much.
We don't even know if he's still got it.
We haven't got any time to waste, Mr. Lee. We know you've got a bomb in there, but what you don't know is that it's very unstable and it could go off at any minute. Now, if I promise not to prosecute you, will you get out and let us deal with it, please?
How do I know you're telling the truth?
I'm Chief Inspector Conway. You can complain about me later if I'm not, okay?
It's in the hall cupboard.
Clear the neighbours. You better come with us. Only to the car park until it's been made safe.
He can't be serious. He's going to let that little prat get away with it.
What were you thinking of? Giving the boy an amnesty, Derek?
I was the officer on the ground. I used my judgment.
It was against my express wishes.
You asked me to go out there and deal with the situation. That's what I did.
Did you try anything else first?
I had no choice, sir.
You could have arrested him on suspicion, gone in and searched.
Yeah, and soon as the others heard about it, they'd be dashing about disposing of the evidence.
We need to make an example of these boys, Derek, or they'll be doing it again. Did you ask the boy if he knew where any other of the devices were?
Yes, and he didn't.
If this gets out, it could hinder the helpline.
Helpline?
Yes, Derek. I've organised a helpline with a number given out on local radio, asking local people for assistance. If it gets out, we're letting the boys off. We can kiss any help goodbye.
Look, a helpline will be jammed solid with calls from worried from Welling Drive before we get any real information. We've got to go out there, sir, and get these kids to talk to us. Let me go and talk to them. We know the majority of people who bought devices were friends and classmates. Let me go to the school, talk to Adam's classmates, address them in small groups, personal contact. Tell them there'll be no prosecutions for anybody who just bought a device, provided they tell us where it is.
Yes. All right then, Derek. But I do not want this becoming common knowledge, just the school.
What do you think you were doing making explosive devices anyway?
It was just a laugh. I didn't even think they'd work.
Why the phone box?
We thought it'd be, I don't know, more exciting than a flower bed. Well, Adam seemed to think so. It was his idea to put on a demonstration after we sold him, you know?
And it didn't cross your tiny little mind at any point that somebody could get hurt?
No. Just down in.
Oh, real home from home. Well, where next?
I don't know. Like you say, all my friends are still at school. You can try their houses, though.
You know, I think we should go to St. Hughes, try and have a word with Adam's parents. Maybe he's gone somewhere like a relative's place, you know.
Well, they wouldn't talk to Jamila.
That's true. Yeah. Mind you, that was earlier. I mean, they were obviously with Craig then, weren't they? Perhaps they've calmed down a little bit now.
You're not taking me there, are you?
Oh, no, Josh. Don't worry, mate. We'll take you back to the station first, drop you off there, right?
Okay, yeah, we'll go to St. Hughes. And you might like to have another checker whilst we're there.
No, why would I want to do that?
Well, look, you're a brave man, Reg, but I know.
Know what?
What you're going through on the inside. I've seen your hands trembling, your eyelid twitching, you're showing all the signs.
A bit shaky, isn't it?
Look, you could be heading for blackouts, uncontrollable emotions, post-traumatic stress. I've seen it all before.
Well, I suppose I could pop into casualty and work with a sister, couldn't I?
Now, personally promise that you won't get into trouble with the police if you just tell us where we can find them. We'll deal with them, make them safe, and as far as we're concerned, that's the end of the story, right? Now, you're the last group I'm speaking to, but I've told the rest of the year exactly the same thing. I'm now going to the headmaster's office to wait for anyone who knows anything about where these devices are to come and talk to me. All right?
Right.
Come on, Eddie, be fair. The boy's 16. You can't expect his parents to know where he is all the time. Mr. Wendell is very distressed.
Look, can't you see? You'd be better off asking one of his class. Yeah, I'm only his parent.
Can we take him outside?
Yeah, listen, we've already been to the school, yeah?
She said that Adam ran away because of what happened to Craig. But I don't understand. How did he know about it?
Well, we told him about the accident.
You told him?
Yeah, well, we had no idea about the other explosive at the time, of course, but...
You mean you had him and you let him go?
Yeah, well, like I said, Mr. Wendell, we had no idea about the other explosive.
My little boy has lost his arm! Amputated below the elbow!
Well, look, I'm really sorry to hear that.
You had the stupid idiot who did it and you let him go?
Well, perhaps Mrs. Wendell knows where Adam is.
No, 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 I'm not disturbing my wife. She's very upset. So why don't you just do your job properly?
We're doing our best to find him, Mr. Wendell.
Yeah, and when you do, you tell him I never want to see him again.
Well, he's a bundle of laughs, isn't he?
Well, how do you think you'd feel if your son had just had his hand amputated?
All too busy.
Who?
Well, a doctor or something. I don't think Reg should be working.
Are you all right, Reg?
Well, a bit shaky, that's all.
Come on then, Reg, if you feel up to it, we'll work through that list of school friends Josh gave us and check none of them are skiving off. You never know, they might have bombs under their beds and all.
Yes, Andrew. I just finished talking to the class and two lads came forward straight away. One of them had a device in his locker at the school. Yeah, we're evacuating that block now. Come in. Yeah, Tony's taken the other boy back to his house to break the news to his mum. Yeah. So that makes six accounted for now. Make that seven, will you? I think I've just been handed another one.
In my flat?
Yeah, that's what he says. It's a homemade bomb.
Vicky, this old kind of joke, eh?
It's in the airing cupboard.
What's all this about then? You tried to kill us? Your dad put you up to this, did he?
Mrs. Dixon, if you wouldn't mind moving down...
You think it would get me out of his hair if the boiler went up and took me with it, did he? Well, you can go and tell him and that tart he's shacked up with that I ain't ever going to leave them alone.
Mrs. Dixon, you said the boiler. When you said the bomb's in the airing cupboard, do you mean it's by a boiler?
The boiler's in the airing cupboard.
Mrs. Dixon, I'm going to have to ask you to leave the flat right now. The bomb's unstable. It could explode and changes of temperature.
Oh,
I'll get a report to
purse.
Mr. Conway. Mrs. Dixon!
What are you two doing here?
Working through a list of Adam Wendell's mates, and this, I take it, is Mickey Dixon.
Yeah, and the device is near a boiler.
Well, that's very clever. So, Mickey, any idea where we might find Adam?
I might have known. Adam Wendell, I told you before, keep away from that boy. He's too sharp for his own good. You find him. Tell him I'd like a word, right?
Yeah, well, you're not the only one, Mrs. Dixon.
Bomb squad's on the way. We're to evacuate the block.
Okay, look, I'll do this for you. Do you want to go upstairs?
Okay.
How about you two? Can you give me a hand?
No, we've got to find out. And besides, I don't think Reggie's too keen to hang around when the boiler might go up.
I'm not sure I am either.
I can't go down to the community centre. It's just not possible.
Why not?
I couldn't leave Jean.
Jean?
My wife.
Sir, I don't want you to leave her. I want you to take her with you.
She won't come. She hasn't been out of the flat in years.
You've got to leave. Both of you. This is a highly dangerous situation. Look, do you need assistance? I could call an ambulance crew to help carry her if she can't manage the stairs.
No, you don't understand. Jean's got agoraphobia. It'll take more than a bomb to get her out of this flat.
Sierra Oscar, 171. We're leaving the Jasmine Island now. We're
hey! Where's the bomb squad then?
Right on the way.
Well, what do they do exactly?
How do you mean?
To keep, make the bomb safe. Do they cut the wires or pull the fuse out?
Well, I don't think the bombs are sophisticated as that, Mrs. Dixon. I expect they'll have some sort of controlled explosion.
What? You mean you're going to blow up my flat?
Well, no, it's all right. They put sandbags around in that to contain it, and then they send in a robot that fires a disruptor. Yeah, that opens up the bomb and explodes it, reducing the strength of the blast. I mean, there still is an explosion, you see, but it's not such a strong one. Mrs. Dixon, where are you going? Please.
That airing cupboard is full. My best negligence in it. No one's going to blow that up.
Mrs. Dixon, you cannot go into your...
Flat. Natives getting restless.
Yes, sir. Stir crazy, yeah?
I want compensation, you know. The council will have to redecorate or else I'm not going to give my permission. You can't just blow up my flat. Where's Mickey? Mickey! You're going to go and tell him.
He's got any sense he'll have left already.
I'll go and see how Captain Evans is getting on. June! June, perhaps you could talk to the residents.
Sir, I think we've got a problem.
What is it?
Look at me, Reg.
What?
Your eyes are twitching again. Look, Reg, you can't go on. Go home. Get some rest. Mr. Conway will understand, yeah?
Well, yeah, I mean, you might be right, but why not the clear it room?
Yeah, go on then.
She won't budge.
She refuses point blank, sir. I'm sorry.
All right, I'll have a word with her in a minute. All right, Gary.
Sir.
Yes, Reg, what is it?
Oh, Mr. Conway, sir. I think you ought to know that, I think I should go up sick.
Well, it is a bit of an inconvenient time, Reg. You have been cleared by the doctor, haven't you?
Well, yes, sir, but I think I'm suffering from post-traumatic stress. See my eyes? Twitching like that. It's a classic symptom.
Is this some kind of wind-up, Reg?
No, sir.
No? Well, you've been to the hospital. They say you're okay. Now go and find this lad who knows where all the other bombs are, or I'll volunteer you for a spot of defusing.
Lisa Carr, I'm Inspector Monroe. I understand you wanted to speak to someone in connection with the explosive devices.
I tried phoning, you know, that number that's out on the radio, but it's constantly engaged.
What did you want to tell us?
It's about a friend might know something about one of these bombs.
And what does this friend know?
No, it ain't me. And I'm not going to dob someone in, not if they're going to get into trouble.
If you know, or anyone else knows, where one of these devices is, you must say.
I've got to be sure you won't give him no hassle, right? Or I'm not saying what I know. Your choice, mate.
These devices are very unpredictable. Anything could set them off.
One of the lads from school was told he wouldn't get done. I want the same deal, right?
You'll have to wait.
Yeah, you go check with your boss, mate. Don't want to do anything wrong, do ya?
If you fire a disruptor into a device, there's no telling how big the bang's going to be. If the boiler goes up with it, your lady could come crashing through the ceiling.
Well, maybe we can move the device to somewhere safer.
Can't do that without risking more people, including myself.
Right. Well, we'll have to shift her then, won't we? I'll see if I can get a doctor to knock her out or something.
Yeah, sooner the better. Can't say I'm keen on having this device sitting next to a ruddy boiler.
Right. She says that a boy at the school was offered an amnesty. Is this really true?
Yes, I'm afraid that's so. Thanks, mate. I was trying to limit its extent, though.
To be fair, sir, how can we expect her to tell us anything now that she knows? Well, unless she gets the same treatment.
All right, Andrew, go and give her the good news. I don't want to be coming general knowledge, though.
No, sir.
You can't make me leave.
We have no choice. You're directly above the device. It's far too dangerous to deal with it with you still here.
Or handed up a lot of discipline.
Look, either you go down to the community centre or we have to move you. You can't keep us and all the other people waiting forever.
I can't do it. Really, I can't. I'm not trying to be difficult.
I know you're not, and I do understand. Look, Martin says you've got some tranquilizers to keep you calm.
I already had one. I mean, a thought of a bomb downstairs. It made me nervous.
It makes us all nervous, Jean. Look, I've spoken to the doctor and he says it's okay for you to have two more tablets under the circumstances.
But he told me never to take more than one.
I know that, Jean, but it is an emergency. Isn't it, Martin?
That's right, love. It'll make you drowsy, but it's all right just this once. And they've got an ambulance waiting. You can sit in there. You don't have to go down to the community centre with all the others.
I don't know. I'm frightened.
Of course you are, love. We all are. Now, take your tablets, like the doctor says. There's a good girl. Yeah. Just a little sip of water to wash them down. That's it. That's good. Well done. We'll give them a few minutes to work and then we'll go on down. It'll be fine.
You won't leave me, will you, Martin?
Of course not, love. I'll be there every step of the way. You wait and see.
Well, I've spoken to the Chief Superintendent, Lisa, and he's agreed that your friend won't be prosecuted.
No tricks?
And not as long as you tell us where it is.
It's at my boyfriend's house. Well, his dad's. It's in a shoebox top of the wardrobe. Only I should warn you, his dad ain't going to be too happy about this.
Your boyfriend hasn't told him?
Big wuss is too scared. Wants to stay with me and my mum till the dust settled.
You're feeling up to it, Jean. Should we give it a try?
I'm sorry, I can't do it. I can't.
I'm going to get that doctor out here if I have to collect him myself. He's got to give us something stronger, not to mention faster, actually.
How much longer are we going to have to wait then? I thought they were just going to go in and blow the thing up.
We've got to clear the other flats first, Mrs. Dixon, just in case.
Well, what's the hold up?
Dr. Meredith.
Go on, get them out!
Come with me.
You're going to love Pete Talbot. One of Sunhill's finest.
What's he known for?
Handling, mainly. Real loser.
Always gets caught.
yeah, he's not very bright. Not the world's most reasonable bloke, either.
Well, no one would be too happy if their son stashed a bomb on top of the wardrobe.
Yeah, well, he's going to be even less happy when he finds out his lad got his girlfriend to tell us about it.
Makes you think, though, doesn't it? I mean, what did he think he was going to do with it?
Who knows?
What do you want?
Oh, Mr. Talbot, can we have a word, please?
Got a warrant?
No, but we...
Then you can't.
What's that? I never knew there was a woman up there. Thought that old Gilders lived on his own. Hey, Mickey, did you know there was a woman up there?
Mr. Talbot! Come on, Pete, just listen to me, will you?
No way.
Mr. Talbot, just let us talk to you. It's about your son, not you.
All about him.
We're concerned about something he's hidden in his bedroom.
Doggy off. My son's no villain. He's not like that. And you still need a warrant. What's he hidden?
It's a homemade bomb.
Don't make me laugh. A bomb? What do you want with one of those?
It's the truth, Pete. He really has. Now, you've got to leave the house.
It's a trick. As soon as you're in, you do a search and plant some stuff.
Oh, sure. So what? I've got a couple of dodgy videos stuffed up my jumper, have I?
Officer, have you got a minute?
What's the problem?
No problem at all, officer. I just wanted to ask you a few questions about this morning's activities. Carter, Sunhill Chronicle. Have you got a minute?
I'm sorry, I'm very busy.
It won't take a minute. Is it true about the amnesties?
Come on, Pete, this is ridiculous. Just open the door, will you?
Take a look for yourself. Top of your son's wardrobe, there's a shoebox. Now, how would I know that if it wasn't true? Put it down. It's very unstable. I said put it down! Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, if you could just move smartly away from the manhole cover, sir. As quickly as you can, please. Thank you. Smartly along, sir. Thank you.
The people aren't coming forward. The helpline's a complete failure.
Give it time, Derek. We've had 24 calls in the last half an hour.
Yeah, they were lucky to get through. There were switchboards jammed.
We're putting in another line.
Yeah, but that won't help, because there's no useful information coming out of there. I mean, it's just people wanting reassurance they're not in danger.
Well, that's part of our job, too. And no, there will be no blanket amnesty.
Sir, yes. The front desk reports that that man from the Chronicle is making a nuisance of himself downstairs.
Impudent scribbler.
Ah, Chief Superintendent Brownlow, just the man...
Do everything we can to cooperate with your newspaper. But your presence here is becoming a nuisance. I must ask you to leave.
Understood. Just one question.
No, I'm very sorry.
Is it true you're not going to prosecute anyone in connection with these bombs?
Where did you hear that?
Canley Comprehensive. The kids are all talking about it.
We will be charging the main perpetrators, of course.
But the others?
We had to gain their trust. Find the other devices.
Smart move.
You think so?
Yes. I would have put you down as the sort of policeman who's only interested in arrest rates. An amnesty is pretty radical.
Well, one has to look at the larger picture. I realised very early on that we'd have to find the other devices before somebody else got hurt.
Refreshingly enlightened, Chief Superintendent. Excuse me. Hello.
Ah. Derek. There you are. Oh, how are things on the front line?
Hang on a minute. Yeah? Yeah, thanks. The papers had a call telling us where to find another bomb.
Where?
A lockup in the alley behind the precinct. That's all the information
we have. Oh, we're getting somewhere.
Probably couldn't get through to the helpline.
Derek, that damn journalist is on his way already.
Sierra Oscar 2-2 from Sierra Oscar receiving, over.
Go ahead, Sarge.
Yeah, the lockup's in the alley behind the precinct, Vicky. There's an IED in one of the lockups. We don't know which one. Verify, isolate, and wait for the bomb squad.
On way, Sarge.
Well, at least there's only one left to find, Sarge.
If the lad can count.
This is a waste of time, Rich.
Yeah, well, Mrs. Wendell said she wanted to see us, and maybe she knows that there's somewhere that Adam might be.
Listen, Rich, you just want to hang around the hospital in case you feel bad.
Don't start that again, Ellie.
It was a joke, Reg, that's all.
Yeah, it was not a very funny one, I might say, sir.
Reg, mate, get a sense of humour, will ya?
Well, where are we going to start?
Let's check the doors, see if any are open.
I'm a journalist. Tom Carter, Sun Hill Chronicle.
I don't care who you are, you've got no right to be in here.
It was open.
Get away from that right now.
Look, it was me who told Chief Superintendent Brownlow that the bomb was here.
If you don't get away from that right now, I'm going to physically drag you away.
What's going on? This is outrageous. I'll be making a complaint to your superior about this.
Yeah, well, he's going to be here in a minute, so feel free. But in the meantime, let's all just get back to a safe distance, yeah?
With all the stupid things to do, he could have killed us.
Yeah, well, you were hardly diplomatic, were you?
There are times for diplomacy, and that wasn't one of them.
Look, he's a journalist. It doesn't matter what you do, as long as it looks good in the papers.
Mrs. Wendell, what was it you wanted to tell us about?
Well, I was thinking you could try the allotments for Adam.
Which ones?
Around the back of Broom Lane. His granddad's got one there, you see, and it's where he goes when he wants to be alone. Sits in the shed.
Thank you, Mrs. Wendell.
He's not a bad boy. Not really.
How do you think he knew which lockup to go to?
Oh, I don't know. Journalist knows.
Nah, he knew.
Oh, Vicky, leave it!
She didn't assault you, Mr. Carter. It was a very dangerous situation and you prevented her from doing her job.
You wouldn't have known about the bomb if it wasn't for me. Just you wait till the locals read about her heavy-handed techniques.
Perhaps you'd like to explain to the Chief Inspector exactly how come you knew which lockup the bomb was in.
You wouldn't happen to have been withholding information, would you, Mr. Carter?
I wasn't aware of the full facts at first. It wasn't until I was on my way here that I was given more information. I had every intention of telling you.
I bet you did. Now, goodbye before I make an official complaint about you, Mr. Carter.
This way, please, sir.
Thank you, sir.
That's not to say I don't think you handled the situation badly, Vicky. Assaulting journalists might be tempting, but it's not to be recommended. A bit more tact next time.
Hello? Hello, can you repeat that, please?
On way to Broom Lane allotment, Sarge.
Receive, Rich.
Sarge, I've just had an anonymous call saying there's a bomb at the Harvey Wallace comp.
Did they say exactly where?
Yeah, under the chair stacked in the hall.
Right, get Gary and Tony over there and alert Mr. Conway.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar.
A Harvey Wallace comprehensive. Suspect device, bomb squad alerted.
Yeah, tell him we'll assist, yeah?
We'll run and have a call.
Look, that's bomb number 10, Reg. There's no rush to find Adam now.
Well, he could be in a state. You don't know what he might do.
Well, who cares? A little scrot who's had us all rushing round all day, clearing up his mess.
How would you like it if one of your pranks went pear-shaped and you ended up permanently maiming your kid, Bummer?
Yeah, I wouldn't be that stupid in the first place, would I?
Oh, really?
What are you trying to say, Rich?
Nothing.
No? Well, you want to hide on the allotments, that's fine with me. Come on.
You can actually see it?
Well, I can see there's a biscuit tin in there, yeah.
I'll send the robot in and get a closer look.
School clear, Tony?
Yes, sir. Most of the kids are bunked off home. Christmas has come early, they
think. Right, come on.
She say which allotment?
Well, I need it out of shed.
Well, we've all got sheds, Reg. Right, listen, I'll take this side, you take that, yeah?
All right. Oh, Eddie, we should switch our radio, sir.
Well, why? We know he hasn't got any bombs on him. They've all been found.
Yeah, well, maybe they made the devices here. There could be explosive materials left.
Don't be such an old woman, Reg.
Eddie, it's correct procedure. If there's any risk that explosive devices or materials are left in the immediate vicinity, all radios must be switched up.
Right. Yeah, happy?
Yeah.
Okay, there it is. Just move in a bit closer. We may be able to see inside the tin as the lid's half off. Oh, I don't believe it.
Oh, for goodness sake.
What a waste of time. Take it down the far end, unload the weapons.
Yes, sir.
It beggars belief. Who'd be irresponsible enough to make a hoax call?
One of the kids probably want to get home early.
So where is it? Where's the last device?
Probably find it at the most obvious place.
Yeah, but where would that be?
Well, the lads made them, I should think.
Josh Haywood's shed. We've been there. And we know they agreed to keep one apiece, and Adam was supposed to sell the rest.
How do we know he did sell them all?
That's true.
We searched his house. Wasn't one there.
Well, if he has kept another one, he's got it elsewhere. Look, I'd better warn Reg and Eddie, he might have one on him. Is this all right?
I don't think that ham sandwich is about to explode.
We've been looking everywhere, have you?
We're having trouble getting hold of Reg and Eddie. They're at the allotments and may not know there's another bomb around.
171 from Sierra Oscar receiving, over.
Any reply?
They must have their radio switched off.
Right, I'll get the air car over there to warn them.
Every time I see him, I'm going to know it was all my fault.
Look, you didn't mean to hurt anyone, we know that. And in the fullness of time, everyone will come to accept it.
You're right, met my dad, have you?
Well, no.
But you heard about him.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar receiving, over.
If they think we found all the devices, why have they got their radios off?
You know, Reg, have a call.
171 from Sierra Oscar receiving.
Come on, Reg, switch your bloody radio on.
Well, at least now we've got all the bombs, you know you can't cause any more trouble.
What do you mean, you can't have?
Josh told us there were 10.
Josh had one. I sold 7 and kept the 2 that were left.
2?
Yeah, one under my bed to sell later. And the other one I hid up here.
Well, where is it?
Where's what?
With the other bomb.
It's in my school bag. In the shed over there.
Adam, listen. Go over to the van. Go on.
171.988
receiving.
Must be here, Reg. Found his bag.
Eddie, put the bag down gently. There's a bomb in it.
Oh, yeah, very funny, Reg. Trying to get back at me, are you?
Eddie, I'm serious.
I never thought of you as a vindictive type. You and I both know all the devices have been found. I'm not that stupid.
Eddie, it's not a wind-up. Put the bag down.
You want it? Come on, come and get it. Go on. That's it.
Down!
Oh!